Hi to everybody and welcome to this new episode of the Tech Pill series. Today I want to talk to you about Gulp Debug. It's this mini utility for Gulp and allow us to debug vinyl's file stream. In other words, we can say what is flowing through our pipeline. Let's start from the very beginning. So the installation command is npm install gulp debug. Let's install it. npm install gulp debug in order to install in the our development dependency. The tool is installed immediately. Before running the gulp file, I want to show you first of all my src directory and then the gulp file. So let's start from the src directory. We have four files, three JS and one HTML. Then let's jump directly to the gulp file. So we have imported gulp, gulp debug and gulp filter. I define two filters, one for JavaScript filter and one for HTML filter. And then I put in pipeline all my src directory, applying a restore.js filter and applying a restore HTML filter. Then let's see what's happened if I run gulp. Okay, there is pretty no information here. So what is flowing through our pipeline? Let's use the gulp debugger. Let's go back to the gulp file JS and start inserting some debugging information. So as usual dot pipe, then debug, and let's pass a title, say all files. Then I'm going to copy this line and I'm putting here just right after the JS filter. So writing JS files and another one here just below the HTML filter, HTML files. So if I run the gulp file now, I expect three kinds of debugging lines, and I am expecting that the gulp debug utility will show me what is flowing through the pipeline at the moment of the debugging instruction. Let's try gulp. Okay, here as you can see we have the first string we have typed in the gulp file and it's saying all files, and this is the first one. Then another all files line, index.html, all files test file js and all files test one js. Then we have a fifth row, all files, that's showing us the number of files flowing to the stream at the moment. Then we have JS files. So first one, let me see, where is the other one? JS files and JS files. As you can see, are the only JavaScript file. And then we have just one line with HTML files that is matching our index.html. And at the end of the output, we have the summary. So all files, we have four items, JS files, three items, and HTML files, one item. Okay, that's all, folks. I think this is enough. This is just only a pill. And see you on the next video. Bye.